Yo, what's up guys? Welcome to, I guess, a new video. This is the first official video on the Light Up Media page. So guys, welcome to the chat. If you're coming from my channel, welcome to this new adventure that me and Nick are both taking. We are the founders of Light Up Media. Nick, did you want to tell them a little bit about yourself?
Yeah. So years and years ago, I actually had a web design company, did photography, advertising, stuff like that. And now I have lots of businesses, you know, in the food industry and the health industry, and lots of different businesses. And so I figured, look, you know, media is the way that things are going, especially with, you know, advertising and stuff like that. So I figured, found Dylan, and I knew he was a up and coming star here.
Big star.
Anyway, so I knew, honing in on some of his skills, he could, help me grow, you know, my existing brands and maybe some other brands along the way.
And really, he's a super creative guy. Like when we go on a lot of shoots, like I'm showing B-roll here, he's a lot of times takes a director role. He knows exactly how to make a shot look good. Like he comes from a design background. And as for me, if you don't know me, I'm Dylan Alvarez, and I've been a YouTuber for the past few years, reacting mainly to BTS and other K-pop groups, hence the video we're doing today. But thankfully, Nick gave me the opportunity to start this Light Up Media, this media company with him. And guys, I mean, it's awesome just being able to explore the videography, learn about it. So on this channel, we're gonna be making a lot of tutorial videos, a lot of behind the scenes shooting, a lot of videos just from the perspective of a beginning videographer and media company. And like I said, along the way, we wanna teach you guys and connect with you guys. So please hit that subscribe button, drop a like on the video if you enjoy it. And so what are we doing today for our first video? You guys know I had to throw a little bit of beat. All right, so you guys might be asking, what are we doing in today's video? We're reacting to GCS because I had to sprinkle a little bit of BTS in there. But we're not doing this alone. We have a friend, but he's not. Jordan! Jordan, yes sir, what's up my dude? So, Jordan Sellers, what's up, in the flesh, with the cup, and the cup, we call that a double cup in this in this enterprise. So, Jordan is a fellow videographer here in town. He's been helping mentor me specifically and helping show us a lot of good stuff, and he has his own YouTube channel, which we're gonna be plugging down in the description below. Neither one of y'all know about BTS that much, right?
No, I really don't.
They look great. They look great in Samsung commercials. Give them that.
That is true. Maybe Jungkook directed that commercial. So guys, we are all three creators, and we're gonna be reacting from an analytical standpoint to BTS's GCS. I'm sorry, Jungkook's GCS.
God, analytical.
I throw out words.
There are so many acronyms.
I got adjectives for days. What? Like straight up, like flamboyant. I swear to God. So you guys might be wondering what a GCF is. It stands for Golden Closet Film, and they're created, directed, edited all by Jungkook, who is the youngest member of BTS.
I'm keeping up.
So there are seven members in BTS. Jungkook is one of the amazing ones. Beautiful vocals, but we'll get to that later. We're touching on his creative side. He did photography as well, which I think is something that you can appreciate, Nick. And we're gonna be reacting to those. So they're kind of like travel vlogs. Every time they travel somewhere, he picks up the camera, which I know you can respect, picks up the camera and just films. And he has some really good subjects with seven beautiful men in BTS. So it's easy, but it's not easy. And we're gonna be judging that today. So now that I explained the GCF, and this is a long intro already, we're super excited to be reacting to it, but that's not the only thing we're doing. Let him know, Nick!
Hey, so look, get this video to 200 likes, and we're gonna try to recreate some of these videos for you guys.
We're gonna do them one at a time. So it's gonna be a series. As long as you guys wanna see it, of course, we're gonna film it, edit it, and break it down for you so you can see how Jungkook puts these together and hopefully start your video journey yourself. At the end of the day, you could be doing all this with a phone. You don't need no expensive camera, expensive editing software. You need iMovie, which is on your iPhone, and a phone of some sort. So we should probably just get into this video.
Yeah, I'm excited. You pumped this thing up for weeks now, so let's see.
Yeah. So this is the GCF in Tokyo back in 2017. And I'll be honest, he's grown a lot since then as a videographer, but I still really like this.
So everything we're watching is them in Tokyo.
Yeah, and it's really just him and Jimin, another member of BTS. So, you know, it's personality and stuff like that.
How many times have you watched this, by the way?
I've 30 times.
Okay.
Easily.
Oh, snap. Dude, those boots are fire.
What's on fire?
Oh, I like the switch.
I know, I like how it builds up. It doesn't just go straight into the music.
Yeah,
kind of like a little intro before the intro.
Like the use of rough ambient audio like that,
yeah,
sets the song up much better when you clean it up.
And something else I like too is the colors in it.
Oh yeah,
that's low light right there. Like, yeah, that's not easy to film.
Super muted.
I think somebody said it. I was joking. This is my favorite part. I'm a nut for those transitions.
Hey.
I don't know if I'm a nut for those transitions.
That was smart.
Now, is this BTS playing music? Is this their
music? No, this is Troye Sivan.
Okay, alright. It didn't sound like BTS.
Now, I think one thing we can note, though, right here, is these transitions. Like, back then, they weren't considered tacky. Like, everybody was on, like, this was like a trend in the editing world, right? Like, those... Yeah. Those transitions, the spin transition. Now people are like, oh, they're overplayed and they're overused and stuff. Bless you. A lot of people are like, now they're overplayed and overused and stuff. But I like the first one especially, and it's funny because he doesn't even use them in his own films. He doesn't use them either anymore.
So, but watch. So when he uses the push, so in the composition, if you look, when he uses that push, it takes like a simple shot that's not necessarily the most cinematic or the greatest, and it adds to like the emphasis of it. So he's just looking at a street.
But he instead push. Of just panning down, he adds a new element to it.
When he's edited to the song as well. So
that's right.
I'm waiting for the drops. I like that.
I like that.
Yeah. So it takes.
Well, he does it.
So watch. Pause. So something simple as that, where he takes. Walking, he literally just walking, getting into a cab. So by syncing it up the music, keeping the framing, keep the framing the same.
Oh,
it adds that little cut. I think it's four of them. Takes a walk to a cab,
and you don't even notice it that much until like you pay attention to it. But it makes it so much more upbeat watching it.
Yeah, it's just a walk to the cab, and it just adds so much.
And you know, he's doing all this handheld. It's just a cool travel vlog at the end of the day. I think he's using a Sony.
So are they able to walk out in public like this? Or are they just kind of.
That's so funny you say that, because I said the same thing in my first time reacting to this.
Yeah, yeah.
But the people in Japan are extremely courteous to celebrities.
Wow. So they don't have like tons of people like paparazzi like crazy.
Apparently not. And not only that, but even if there's huge fans there, they're very respectful of the privacy and they let them walk around and live normally.
Yeah. Well, because I'm sure somebody even following you with the camera is still gonna, draw more attention
and
to you as
well. I think maybe with them, maybe you don't notice them unless the whole group's together.
No. It's like you notice them.
Oh really?
Like, Jimmy was in front of me right there, I think.
Oh, see, I don't recognize him by himself. I really don't.
That's big.
But like, if he was on Ellen with the whole group, I'd be like, oh, he's the one that was on the left, right? Like, I recognize him.
Well, we're talking about from like a fan's perspective.
You'd see him from.
Is it a fan or fanboy? Which
I'm a fanboy, 100%. Fanboy. I'm not even judging right now. But I'm a videographer right now. So we're gonna keep playing.
Well, he's got some dope style.
I know, right? The leather jacket. So Jordan,
bar at the bottom too. It's not fully blacked out. It's just
I know it makes it. It gives that letterbox a little bit more So guys,
I've never seen that before, honestly.
So sometimes what people will do is they'll crop it out and add those movies.
Cinematic bars. Yeah.
And that's what Jungkook did.
Yeah, it's a 235 crop. So I use it.
You use it for what?
I use it a lot. I use it less because dang, everybody expects. Square and
because so like a social media, right?
When I post things on Instagram, it drives me crazy that it seems so small. But I love what it does to the shot.
I do too. It almost makes it more cinematic.
Oh, it does.
Got this. He shoots better. He shoots better handheld than I do with the gimbal.
Do we know what he films with?
I don't know. If y'all could let us know down in the comments below, it's to Sony.
Can I guess?
Yeah.
I think it's like a Sony, like an A6600 maybe.
I remember A6 being part of what he shoots.
It looks like an A6600, something like that. It's got that vibe.
Hey, y'all comment down below. If he gets that right,
that's ridiculous. That's ridiculous.
That's ridiculous.
He's shooting probably around like sunset here. I was saying near sunset.
Yeah, you can see it starting to kind of drop.
He has a good understanding of... just like exposure, and he shot in a color profile that requires like very little grading, and so I think he's walking around with good exposure, and just saying I'm more focused on him and what he's doing. That's actually a very tough shot to not make look crappy.
Because he's like, shooting in the sunlight.
He's shooting in the sunlight. So he has a good enough understanding of his camera's limitations and he has a good eye for it to take what should be like a 4 out of 10 shot and make it a 7 or 8 out of 10 shot.
And it attests to the fact that it doesn't matter how good of a camera you have, if you don't know how to use it, it's not going to look good.
Yeah, absolutely.
He knows how to use it. And he's walking, he's just cutting to the beat. And probably people don't think about it. Oh, wait, I like this.
I love that. The smile, I love that.
Like, now, is this his first?
All right, there it is. So that's a little peek on it. That's a little peek at the camera right there. I'm not sure if you can even see it.
Well,
I'm not sure.
There's some pretty hardcore BTS fans out there that might be able to.
Go back. Let's do it. Since we're here. Pause.
Go back one frame.
Go back one frame. Pause. That's Canon, not Sony.
Are you sure?
No, that's an alpha symbol. That's totally an alpha symbol because it's.
That symbol right there, you're saying?
Yep, that's an alpha symbol, and
It might be Sony.
I think it's a Sony. I looked at videos on this.
I think that is a Sony.
It could be A7III.
It's either A7III or like an A7.
And A7III goes back to 2017?
When it came out.
I'm going to put my money on.
Yeah.
He probably likes photography too.
He does,
I'm
going to
put
does.
My money on A7R Mark II. There you go.
Dude, y'all let us know down in the comments below. We need to know.
I changed. I'm hanging out with fellow nerds I never get to. Like, I mean, I'm going to wear it proudly. Like, let's go.
Hey, if he gets that right, y'all got to go subscribe to his channel. Y'all got to.
His props right there if he does.
Do his hair is fire.
Now, is this his first GCS he's ever done?
GCS 100.
Okay. So
you need to see the newest one. You need to see the newest one.
So has he, you feel like he's progressed either?
Oh, so much. So much.
Okay.
I love this shot
that's
right
beautiful.
Here.
Wow.
That's just going.
He had to
like,
use a gimbal for that, huh?
I don't think he did.
He was riding on an escalator. I think he was riding on an escalator.
But he used that framing so well.
I know. I love the side.
And there's a beauty to it being kind of rocky, like not being so smooth, right? Making it more like.
Well, it looked pretty smooth to me.
Yeah.
That one shot was.
What do you think? This was like 50 millimeters, given that documentary kind of feel on his lens.
It's really hard to tell. That's 18 mil. That's 18 or 24.
I like
that's
shot.
Pretty.
That was cool.
I don't even know how he did that.
It's like you're
right
in a
there.
Daze right there.
That was like a little morph. I don't even know how he did that. Wait, you think it was a vertigo effect? Do you think he was doing a vertigo right there where he was like panning in and zooming out? Like that was one of the shots that always confused me.
Go back
me.
Like 10 seconds.
Like you ever grab your phone and move it forward but zoom out? Like with your thumb?
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
It creates that weird like effect? Like when
that's exactly what that is, yeah.
When we recreate that, that's going to be probably one of the harder shots to do, I would think, right? Because he still keeps him in a good framing the entire time.
Who do we have? So we have to find a friend that looks this
you might
cool.
be the friend.
You think I look that good? Did you
I,
see,
no, I don't.
Did
I
you
don't.
See
I,
this
you
dude's
don't.
Hair? Like...
Yeah, I did. You don't look that good, no.
Okay, I'll make a deal with you. I'll make a deal with you. I'll be him if you buy me that outfit.
I don't like that.
That's probably an expensive outfit.
I don't think you understand how much he's wearing right now.
Yeah, that big jacket's probably 2 G's.
Okay. Like, be honest, Jordan. Yeah. Yeah.
All right, I like that. That's tight.
Dude, they're
that
so made me hungry.
Like, they're so happy. I love. I think they like.
Oh, I love the zoom out of the restaurant
shot. Yeah.
See, I like that.
It went with the beat.
I know. Didn't that light
that
go with the
go
beat?
That did go with the beat. And so.
Hey,
oh,
that's
tight. I wonder if he did a. He probably did
a speed
ramp.
Yeah.
He speed ramped it to beat. So here's my like cinematographer. I'm a story guy more than
right.
a cinematographer. So I think he's doing something that a lot of people should take note from. If you go back like 20 seconds. I think he's focusing on end story way more than cinematic quality in the moment. So when he's looking out the window, I think he has like some subtle exposure concerns and some tiny little camera tweaks that he could maybe improve, but you don't notice any of them because he paces it with the song and I'm like, oh, I want to see his face again. Like I'm waiting for that.
Yeah.
And so he's more focused on story. And in that moment, I guarantee you, he was probably like this. He's probably like, just happy
just
while he's
happy
going.
Seeing
he's
the
not
shot.
Going. He's not going. Oh damn, my exposure's a little off. Oh, my ISO's a little off. Because I think you would sense that in this So when you're filming things, you'll end up with not enough B-roll, and you'll end up with less of a story if you're over anxious about every shot being perfect.
That is so crazy you say that, because like, that kind of reminds me of the beauty of just picking up your camera and going and filming something. Because like, you know, like we have all these paid shoots now, like these responsibilities, these gigs. So it's like, we're really anxious about making it look good.
Oh yeah.
Without remembering where we came from and just telling a fun story that people can enjoy watching.
So. Well, yeah, that's like, if they go to my channel, they'll see the little random story about my daughter. I was like in the middle of a shoot and I messed the shoot up and we didn't finish, and so I just said, I have to go pick up my daughter from daycare. Oh, let me tell you a little story about her. And it got more, I was happier about that than the freaking 40-minute long video shoot we just done. And I was like, why don't we do this more often?
Right.
Yeah. That, so.
Man, let's just go to Japan.
Let's just go. It's so pretty there, but that's the whole thing. He is happy when he's filmed. You can tell. He is actually enjoying this.
Yeah, 100%. And the fact that he'll, you know, they'll be always be able to go back and rewatch this. This video, and kind of remember some things, about their trip. So
that's really what the heck?
Yeah, because that's how you know it's a story. I'm in a good mood watching. I listen to them, but I don't listen to them. I don't follow them on social, and I'm like in a good mood watching this video.
That's feel good stuff, right? Feel good stuff. And what do you think about like the composition and the coloring and all that stuff? Like
yeah,
that?
No. So does he use? Is it always this filter for all the GCS, or does he kind of?
No, he's
it up?
Like you notice that little overlay.
Yeah.
That little like
haze,
this little
the white haze. Yeah.
He doesn't. He used it on his. I think he used it in the Osaka one, but this one is just. I think he was just playing around with it. Mm-hmm. And I actually do like the use of it in some of these shots right here. It makes it look a little bit like.
It's kind of a little cinematic too. I like it. I think it fits.
That is such. You always tell me it's the little details that make the biggest difference, and that was such a little detail.
That was great.
Oh, I love that transition.
That's fine. He's exposing properly the whole time.
And you know it's him because he's right there. It's just one other person. Even as he's dizzy, boy, he's just how do you keep that shot?
I want to be.
And I love his hat. He got Mickey Mouse on his hat.
Dude, that's hilarious.
I know you're Disney now because you went for like 2 weeks. Yeah. But so this might be traumatic.
Well, but no. Disney's the happiest place on earth, man.
For 2 weeks?
I'd love to go to Tokyo Disney, though. That would be so much fun, dude. That's the one I haven't been to that one.
So he doesn't do anything complicated in this. He doesn't. It's just cut. Just telling you how.
But he covers before the drop.
Okay,
he
that's a good composition.
That's
right
a
there.
Great composition.
That's a great composition right there.
But he covers two like the most basic things. If you get to know me, I do this stupid hand thing.
You do
so
do
much.
That a lot.
Gotta do it all the time.
But this is your thing.
Dude, this is my thing. So
this is
one extreme bass.
Well,
how was it?
I was a little disappointed.
He hears it all the time.
The point is, he does something very, very important. He understands the base settings and capabilities of his camera.
And I know he studies. He watches a lot of YouTube videos. Also.
Yeah, and so there's some of these shots where the like underexposure, overexposure is these little moments where if you would sit there in it, you'd be like, oh, let's film it again. My exposure is a little off.
Right.
Oh, let's do this. Let's do it again.
And you can't redo stuff like that.
No, and in those moments, it's like he knows the capabilities of his camera and he gets it the best he can. And then he focuses on like loving the moment, right?
Yeah.
And so that's very, very important is you have to understand your camera's capabilities. And if your camera is only 7 out of 10, then stop, make it 7 out of 10, and move to the story
make
on the
story
other
end. Make the story
10
out of
10. And he, like, yeah, he's got, this camera has, it has some limitations. I don't even notice.
Oh, this is a nice
dude, he nails it. He's like an exposure
like
king.
Like I slowed it down, too.
Oh, you caught that?
Little.
Oh, go back.
Now, he
last
edits
two
all
shots.
This, too?
He edits everything.
JK is
Jungkook. Okay. It's his abbreviation.
So, go back like 20 seconds. Y'all's a great catch. And so
you think he slowed it down or was shot slow?
No.
Like,
He filmed it 60 frames is what it looks like. I think he filmed it 60
slowed
frames.
Slowed it down to 24.
Slowed it down just a little. Or filmed in 30 and slowed it down like 10 or 15%. Is there a frame drag? Yeah, he probably filmed at 30 and slowed it down like 20%. That's that little frame drag on his arms, but did we notice? No. You were like, oh, he's happy and slow motion dancing. Yeah.
So, is this something that we can remake?
Oh, snap.
Nick, are you down to try it?
I'm down.
Oh, of course.
I'm down. I mean,
this I'm not stuff, being negative Nancy. I was just
this stuff is fun to me,
it's,
right?
It, but you got to realize 2 minutes and 42 seconds was probably like 4 hours of shooting.
Oh, yeah. Easy.
So
3 minutes and 42 seconds, yeah.
So here's why by default I'm just down for this is because this is easy to do. It's not simple. It's easy. Mm-hmm. So usually when we look at a composition for a client, we have to think of the story, the end user, the locations, the this, that, and the other. And so it's just way more pressure.
Right.
This one is the complete opposite. It's have fun, hold a camera, have your camera set correctly, be in the moment, but you have to find a freaking place that looks good on camera.
It's true.
So it's total opposite.
Yeah.
Usually
we just got hit by a hurricane.
Yeah, I mean, so usually we're filming in an office for somebody or like a fitness location. Or
this is
or
all over the place.
This is the opposite. Instead of being pressured by the camera settings and the moving equipment, it's
setting,
and which is totally the opposite. That almost excites me. Like, what a good pressure!
Oh yeah, because it gives us a good reason to go somewhere.
Yeah, it's way more relaxing than I hope this does well or I don't get paid. Like, this is, let's go have fun in a location that looks awesome.
Yeah.
Like, what a setup.
Yeah, obviously, we don't have Disney World here or anything. No. So we'll have to try to recreate, you know, the
environment.
Scenes and environments as much as we can, but
we could go out to the country, like, in the swamps, and then just try to make it look like we have,
let's put some dangly lights on there.
Yeah, do like, maybe
get the alligator going crawfish boil.
Yeah, go put some hip boots on and be like, bum, bum, bum.
We could make it our own. We could make it our own and emulate the style.
Yeah, y'all comment below how you guys think we should do it because, you know, obviously we're not in Tokyo, you know, but we want this to look like a GCF film. So y'all give us some suggestions on how we can maybe recreate this if we get to 200 likes, right?
If we get 200 likes. So make sure to drop a like on it. If you enjoyed it, of course. Guys, Jordan, thank you so much for giving your insight, being on the channel.
Thank
of course, you, Nick, thank you for joining me on this one, guys. Look forward to a ton of amazing content on this channel. And we'll see you guys on the next video. Peace out, y'all.